Ladies, let's talk about your cycle. Specifically, let's talk about headaches, diarrhea, and anything that feels like it could be allergies that correlates with your menstrual cycle. Hi, I'm Dr. Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com, and this is Chris Masterjohn Lite, where the name of the game is details, schmeetails, just tell me what works. And today we're going to talk about how the menstrual cycle can correlate with histamine intolerance. I recently had a client ask me, I've been suffering from migraines. Is there anything nutritional that you would suggest for migraines? And I said, well, are there any food triggers of your migraines? And she said, no. And I said, well, do they correspond to your menstrual cycle at all? And she said, actually, they usually occur on day 13 of my menstrual cycle, and sometimes they also occur a few days before menstruation starts. Lo and behold, these are the two peaks of estrogen in the menstrual cycle. The first peak is the highest peak. It's also when the estrogen to progesterone ratio is the highest, and it occurs towards the end of ovulation. And then a few days before you start menstruating, you get another second peak of estrogen. It's not as high as the first peak, but it is a second peak, and it's the estrogen to progesterone ratio is not as high because that's when your progesterone is also peaking. So the first thing I think is, well, how does estrogen relate to diamine oxidase, which is the enzyme that helps you clear histamine, knowing that migraines are one of the symptoms of histamine intolerance? And as it turns out, estrogen profoundly decreases your diamine oxidase activity to the point where high estrogen levels would be expected to cause you to become temporarily histamine intolerant. As I've discussed in previous episodes, the symptoms of histamine intolerance could include migraines, but not only migraines, but also other types of headaches, diarrhea, and things that look a lot like allergies, nasal congestion, asthma-like symptoms, wheezing, low blood pressure, heart palpitations when your heart feels like it's skipping or fluttering or beating irregularly, hives, itching, and flushing. If these things correlate with your menstrual cycle and with the estrogen peaks, it could well be because you have become temporarily histamine intolerant. Now, what would you do in a situation like that? Well, what I would suggest is getting a diamine oxidase supplement. In the previous episode, which I'll link to in the description, I recommended Seeking Health Histamine Block or Ancestral Kidney Extract, taking one of the Seeking Health Histamine Block before 15 minutes before eating histamine inclusive foods, and two of the kidney extract capsules at the same time. So 15 minutes before you eat foods that have histamine in them. What I would do is I would get these supplements and keep them to only use during the parts of your menstrual cycle where you expect these symptoms to occur. And then I would dose them preventatively. So if you expect the headaches to come day 13, give or take one day, start taking these supplements with your foods on day 12, take it on day 13, take it on day 14, just to cover that window and see if that reduces or eliminates the symptoms. Ideally, taking this would prevent the development of those symptoms. If it does work, then you have a solution that you can essentially carry around with you. And the fact that you're only taking it a few days per month makes it much more affordable to use those supplements. That's a much better position than not seeing the pattern and not knowing when the symptoms are going to come and having to take something like that all the time. Now, interestingly enough, you would think that, geez, if estrogen is making diamine oxidase activity go down, then pregnancy should make you really histamine intolerant. And in fact, the opposite of that is true. Why? Because the placenta makes massive amounts of diamine oxidase. In fact, in pregnant women, diamine oxidase levels can go up 500 times what they normally are. And many women who are histamine intolerant find that the histamine intolerance goes away during pregnancy, despite whatever other discomforts they may experience at that time. So, depending on your finances, your goals, and your general outlook on life, another way to address histamine intolerance would be to get pregnant.
This episode is brought to you by Ancestral Supplements Living Collagen. Our Native American ancestors believed that eating the organs from a healthy animal would support the health of the corresponding organ of the individual. Ancestral Supplements has a nose-to-tail product line of grass-fed liver, organs, living collagen, bone marrow, and more, all in the convenience of a capsule. For more information or to buy any of their products, go to ancestralsupplements.com. This episode is brought to you by Ample. Ample is a meal in a bottle that takes a total of 2 minutes to prepare, consume, and clean up. It provides a balance of fat, protein, and carbs, plus all the vitamins and minerals you need in a single meal, all from a blend of natural ingredients. It's available in original, vegan, and keto versions, portioned as either 400 or 600 calories per meal. I'm an advisor to Ample, and I use it to save time when I'm working on major projects on a tight schedule. It keeps my brain going while I power through the day, never letting food prep get in the way of my productivity. Head to amplemeal.com and enter the promo code CHRIS15 at checkout for a 15% discount off your first order.
The audio of this episode was enhanced and post-processed by Bob Devodian of Torian Mixing. You can find more of his work at torianonlinemixing.com. All right, I hope you found this useful. Signing off, this is Chris Masterjohn of chrismasterjohnphd.com. This has been Chris Masterjohn Lite, and I will see you in the next episode.